So for the player stats, first like the player card, where you can see the overall performance of a player in terms of play types. You can see the black bar here, which represents the previous rank, previous season rank. That would be the percentile of this category last season. So you can see the green bar, which is for this season, 67th percentile overall. Last season, that would be worse, 55 percentile. So he's been better overall. Then we can see in terms of each situation. For example, last season he was better on isolation plays, but on pick and roll handler he's been a bit better, and we can also see on the info the number of possessions per game. So we are interested in efficiency, that would be points per possession, but also in volume, and we can see that we can easily change to other players and see, well, the comparison between this season and last season. We can see some overachievers and underachievers compared to last season, and we also have defensive data. Even though I always say that defensive stats individually are a bit tricky, you can take a look at that and compare the efficiency and the volume he's getting. If you prefer, you also have here the table to see number by number. As this is a sample of our work, we are focusing on two players, one a point guard, Clemin Hana, and center Musa Diagne. So you can get the feel of what we are doing here with our analysis and how we manage data to give you deeper information. For Clemin Hana, as we said, he's been really good, but then we go to the distribution of some plays. For example, pick and roll situations, he's been very good. We mentioned percentiles. If we add Eurocup, then we can see a bigger sample, and for these pick and roll situations, we can divide between shooting, where he's the one who's finishing, or passing, when he's creating for his teammates, right? So we can see the points per possession, the volume of possessions, field goals, and also important, the percentage of turnovers. We can also compare to last season, when he was with another team, on different situations of pick and roll passing. Then some maps from Instat to see if there's differences between which side he prefers. For example, if we are analyzing an opponent, if we see that he has the tendency to go to the right, or if he is more efficient to the right, then we try to do something defensively, or at least tell the player who is going to guard him that these are the tendencies of the players. In terms of ball handling, as he's a point guard, he's going to have the ball a lot. We did a look at basic stats like assists and turnovers, the percentages, but also going a bit further, just turnovers for pick and roll when he is finishing. So that has gone down from 19% last season to 12%, which is a huge drop. Although when he's being the passer in the pick and roll, it has increased. So if we go to the overall pick and roll situations, it hasn't dropped a lot, but if we take into account that he's going to be handling lots of possessions, as we can see, 440 possessions with fewer matches than expected this season, or 600 possessions last season, that's a lot. So decreasing turnovers is important. And we can see some comparisons with players that are, for example, here we have Hana and Sendlin, who are teammates, and see where one has been better or worse, where we can change some finishing in possessions, maybe for this year playing them together. And other players like Bildoza, different profiles of player, but on the same position, like Bildoza, Hales, Basas, Huertas. So you can get to see the comparison, maybe for the front office, if you want to find similar players or better players in certain play types. We have this as a specific tool. Where you can find similar profiles and other useful information that can detect good players in smaller markets or young players that are about to make a step forward and are cheaper, obviously. So with Moussa Diagne, obviously the analysis is not going to be the same because they play different situations, obviously pick and roll, but as a roller. So we see he's an efficient player even with high volume. He's gone down a bit this season on efficiency. As I said, the short season, so sample is not that big. Maybe he would have been better in the second half of the season, but we can expect he will be around 1.2 points per possession. But we can see, we can go deeper on analysis and see that there has been a great increase on pick and pop. He used to play very little situations on pick and pop, like 12% of pick and roll situations, not overall, but from pick and roll, from 145 possessions, only 18 were pick and pop, while 97 possessions this season he has played 39 as a pick and pop, which is a 40%. And in terms of efficiency, he's good. He's over 50%. So if we have a normal season in 2021 with around 50 games between ACB and EuroCup, that could be around 100 shots from pick and pop. So it would be smart to take this into account. He's only shot two pointers from that pick and pop. Maybe you can try making him shoot some 3-point shots if he's comfortable, not only in terms of efficiency, but also to bring out the opponent center and have some more space on the paint. Obviously, these profiles are out of the blue, so if we have some info or intel from the team, or some specific needs, or you want to focus more, for example, of pick and roll, we could go deeper and see specific situations and give you data for that. But for now, you can see an outlook of how he's performed this season.